BioMistral is a suite of Mistral-based, further pre-trained open-source models suited for the medical domains and pre-trained using textual data from PubMed Central Open Access. All the models of this suite are trained using the CNRS, which stands for French National Center for Scientific Research. In this video, I'm going to show you this one of the best medical LLM on the market at the moment. This LLM is unique in quite a lot of manners. As we know that LLMs have demonstrated remarkable versatility in recent years, offering potential applications across specialized domains such as healthcare and medicine. Despite the availability of various open source LLMs tailored for health context, adapting general purpose LLMs to the medical domain presents significant challenges. That is where this BioMistral shines. It is an open source LLM tailored for the biomedical domain, utilizing Mistral as its foundation model and further pre-trained on PubMed Central. The researchers behind this model have conducted a comprehensive evaluation of BioMistral on a benchmark comprising 10 established medical question answering tasks in English. They have also explored lightweight models obtained through quantization and model merging approaches. Their results demonstrate that BioMistral's superior performance compared to existing open source medical models and its competitive edge against proprietary counterparts. They have also addressed the limited availability of data beyond English and to assess the multilingual generalization of medical LLMs. And that is why they have automatically translated and evaluated this benchmark into 7 other languages, which is awesome. This marks the first large-scale multilingual evaluation of LLMs in the medical domain. And everything they have done is freely released, which includes dataset, multilingual evaluation benchmarks, scripts, and all the models. And I will share the link to this Hugging Face card of BioMistral in video's description. Okay, this is a paper where they have described this everything in great detail, and hats off to all of these researchers. Now, let's install this locally on Windows. I'll be using LM Studio as a tool to get it installed, and I have one GPU of 16 GB of VRAM plus 32 GB of RAM on my local system. So let's get started. The tool which I'm going to use for this purpose is called as LM Studio, and let me make my screen a bit bigger so that you could see properly. There you go. If you don't know what LM Studio is, I have done various videos on LM Studio as how to install it and all the details. So please check the channel, and I'll also drop the link in video's description. Launch LM Studio on the Windows, then go to its home page on the top left, then type BioMistral, press enter, and you can see there are a lot of quantized version here. I have just gone with BioMistral's own quantized version, and I downloaded this Q5KS, and I have done videos around what exactly mean by this Q5, Q4, which are the quantization level. Now, if you click on this folder icon on the left, you will see that this file is already loaded. And then if you click on these three dots and then click on center, and the model is loaded already, and I am offloading all possible layers to GPU by specifying -1. Now let's talk with this model, and let me make it bit fixed on the screen so that you'll be able to see what I'm typing. Let me adjust the screen. There you go, much better. Now I'm going to ask it that a 42-year-old male presents with chest pain, shortness of breath, and nausea. What are the most likely differential diagnoses? Now, before I show you how these prompts and all this stuff, please make sure that context is very important here. This is only for educational purposes. Never take any LLM medical advice on the surface. Always go see your physician, your doctor, and then act accordingly. All of these things, because all of these medical LLMs, they might give you wrong information, and they have varying abilities. And this is maybe just for educational purposes and research purposes good, but it's not for real life use at the moment. Okay, now this prompt which I have just given is primarily testing the LLM's ability to generate a broad list of potential causes based on common symptoms. There you go, it is saying the most likely differential diagnosis for this patient include acute coronary syndrome, pulmonary embolism, and all that stuff. looks, you know, genuine to me. I'm not a doctor or anything, so the words list seems quite heavy and impressive, so must be right. Anyway, I'm just kidding. So maybe if you're a medical student or medical professional, please let us know if it corrects. I have checked these responses from ChatGPT and others. Looks quite okay to me. Anyway, let's do another test where we are going to evaluate the LLM's understanding of specific disease diagnostic process. So I'm going to ask it, how is diagnosis of rheumatoid arthritis established? What are the key diagnosis criteria? Now there you go. So it is saying that it is telling us all the criteria, like presence of three or more of symptoms, morning stiffness, and a lot of other things, x-ray finding, exclusion of other, seems quite good to me. Okay, now let's check another test where we are testing the LLM's ability to consider patient's comorbidities when recommending treatment strategies. And pardon if I'm unable to pronounce these medical terms correctly. Okay, there you go. So it is telling us all the stuff. And remember, this is a quantized version. It's not a full model, but look at how cool the responses is. Now let's probe LLM's knowledge of pharmacological interactions. So I'm going to ask it this question here, that a patient is taking warfarin, what are the potential drug interaction to be aware of? Wow, how cool is that? I also googled it, seems spot on. Amazing stuff. Now in the next test, let's assess the LLM's grasp of underlying disease mechanism. So for that, the prompt I'm going to use is this: describe the pathophysiology of acute pancreatitis. Wow, amazing. So it is just telling us all the stuff, that what exactly this acute pancreatitis is. Amazing stuff. Beautiful response. Very cool. Now let's check that around that LLM's ability to identify key pieces of missing information. Let me paste the prompt first. So I'm asking, a 35-year-old female with a history of asthma presents with worsening shortness of breath. What additional information would you need? And then it is saying, if I was to manage this patient, then the following information would be helpful to me: allergy, medication, and all that stuff. Beautiful. Sounds really good to me. Now let's check that LLM's understanding of the progression of disease and its sequelae, maybe. Okay, let's check it out. The prompt which does that is, what are the potential long-term complications of uncontrolled type 2 diabetes? There you go. Wow. So these are all the complications. So I think I know one thing or two, because I know a few people who have it. So seems quite relevant to me. Amazing stuff. Now let's check or assess the LLM's ability to generate patient-friendly, actionable information. For that, I'm asking, provide patient education material about the prevention of skin cancer. So it is, there you go. You can see how cool, how quality response that is. It is saying skin cancer is a serious health issue that can be prevented by taking proper precaution. Amazing stuff. And then it is going into the detail as how to do it. Beautiful response. Now let's check or challenge the LLM to understand and critically evaluate medical research. For that, I'm using this prompt. I'm saying, a recent study suggests a new treatment for multiple sclerosis. Summarize the key finding and limitation of the study. Wow. And then it is going into that study and giving us all the required information. And how cool is that? Finally, let's ask it a question which I'm sure you all want to ask. So let's see, can I use pills for penis enlargements? Do they really work? Are there any side effects? Let's see. There is no scientific evidence to support the effectiveness of medication or supplements for penis enlargement. These products are not regulated by FDA. That is good. Okay, so please don't do this. Now, I think that this model is amazing. I'm very keen to know your thoughts on it. What do you think? I'll drop the link to its card into video description too. Please share your thoughts in the comment section. And if you like the content, please consider subscribing to the channel. And do me a personal favor, if you're already subscribed, then, or if not, please share the video or the channel among your network. on your social media, anywhere you like, as it helps a lot, and I'll be very indebted. Thanks for watching.